If you're diabetic, looking to control your blood sugars, and would like to know how to get accurate readings from the single most important tool that we have, the glucose meter, then I want you to stay tuned because this is an episode for you. I will not only cover the several mistakes I see many make, but the tips to ensure the most accurate and the most consistent of readings. But before we begin, I'll need you to hit the alerts, the notification button. That'll let you know when the next episode will be released, which is that gray bell on top of the screen. Can you hear it? Reminder, if you're new to YouTube, that clicking that bell will always let you know when that new episode is ready. The subscribe button, and if you like what you've heard today, the like button. All these notifications are really important to me as a brand new channel. And finally, please share this with other diabetics you know that may be struggling or looking to learn. This episode is not only geared for those who are newly diagnosed, but those looking to really understand why so many variances can occur. This is especially important for those of us who are on insulin. And for me, I'm on two different kinds of insulin. So these false readings will have you overcompensating in the opposite direction. For example, the meter says you're at 160 milligrams per deciliter, but because you didn't follow procedures, you're really at 100. So what do? You end up taking more insulin than it's required. You end up hypoglycemic, right? And that left you wondering, did I take too much insulin? What just happened? Your readings were wrong, okay? Let's preface this by saying, glucose meters are designed to give what they say is reasonably accurate test results, meaning results can be within 20% of what a lab test would be. So say, for example, your glucose meter results says it was 100 milligrams per deciliter. It could vary on the downside to 80 or on the upside to 120, and it would still be considered clinically accurate. Now, I took a picture of two examples of my meters that were taken yesterday morning, first thing in the morning, and you can see the difference. One is at 61, and one is at 77. That's just so I can remind you again, glucose meters are designed to give reasonably accurate test results. Now, what are the best ways to measure accuracy on a meter, especially if you've got a new one? Well, you can take it with you when you have your blood drawn. Check your blood with your meter immediately after you've had your blood glucose test done. Nothing is perfect, but for the best results, request that lab process your blood sample within 30 minutes after drawing blood. All right. Now, here are some tips directly related to your meter. It is recommended by the blood glucose manufacturers, especially for those of us who are diabetic, that you should be replacing them every 1 to 2 years. Some manufacturers are 3 to 4. But that all depends on how diligent you are in terms of proper maintenance. Now, these meters are obviously not very expensive. As you know, it's the strips that will break the bank. Second thing about manufacturers, each one will have a different degree of accuracy. Some manufacturers are actually more accurate than others. Why? Because each blood glucose meter uses a different technology to produce those readings. So, one big mistake. If you're using multiple different kinds of meters, be prepared to see some serious inconsistencies. All right? Now, I do have 3 meters here at home. One upstairs in my bathroom, one here right now in my office, and I carry one with me everywhere I go, and that's in my gym bag. But they are all from the same manufacturer. The reason why I need 3 is because, one, I work out twice a day. I do cardio first thing in the morning, and I do weights at night, and I'm active at work all day long. So I'll take an average of about 5 to 6 readings a day. So these life-saving meters are basically, they're around me all day long. Now, what about those test strips? Once those test strips are opened and exposed to the environment, they're only good for 4 months. Okay? Those test solutions are only good for 3 months. All right? Now on to the tips, the important tips. First and foremost, wash your hands. The single most important step you can take to really get that accurate reading is to wash the hands with soap and water before you prick your finger. I always do that, okay? Is infection the concern? No, not really. It's about the contamination or the residue on the hands from eating food or touching something that has sugars on it or even lotion on hands. It's enough to throw off the readings, okay? So if you are without soap and water, use alcohol pads. We are all pretty familiar with these guys. I basically keep them in all of my bags, okay? Worst case scenario, hand washing is impossible, nor do you have alcohol pads. What you do then is you've got to wipe that first sample of blood and use that second drop, all right? Second big mistake, make sure your hands are dry. Excessive water or alcohol can dilute that blood sample, affecting your readings. Simple. Now, here's where another big common mistake is made. So you've just washed your hands and you're going to dry them off. What do you use? Make sure it's clean. Is it a used napkin or even a dish towel you thought was clean? What you may have just done is recontaminate your fingers. Again, so it's not really the bacteria we're concerned with. It's the organic material from food coming back in contact with your hands again. All right? Third, use your fingertips. All right? There are meters out there that allow for pricking alternative sites such as the palms and the forearms. But the results from those sites may not reflect current blood glucose levels. Why is that? Because blood circulation to the rest of the arm takes a little longer than to the fingertips. So there's possibly going to be a lag between the blood sugar readings on the arm versus what happens in the fingertips. The fingertips are generally considered the most accurate place to get blood samples, especially if you've just eaten or have taken insulin. All right? Third, critical, use the right test strip. Besides using expired or outdated strips, what we've just talked about, using the correct strips and storing them properly are really critically important. Now, obviously, the cost of diabetes management is astronomical. Two of the most important and the most expensive items we need are those test strips, and for me personally, it's those long-acting insulins. I can see why so many go to the net looking for the cheapest alternative to fit certain brands. But here's the problem with these cheaper knockoffs. Strips that are not approved for your meter can lead to incorrect and inconsistent readings, and you know what that will do, all right? Now, properly storing your strips is also critical, as we've mentioned. I've even seen people carry them loose in their pockets or loose in their kits. Keep them tightly sealed in their containers. A couple of notes that I found out for myself. Try not to calibrate your glucose meter when your blood sugars are really low or when they're changing. You will add into some inconsistencies. I find the best time to calibrate it is, say, right before bed at night, where my hands are clean and my blood glucose levels tend to be very stable. Also, when in doubt, use that second finger stick. I sometimes find that the meter readings is falsely high. That's from me not washing my hands properly. This strategy has helped. It's helped prevent me from, how I put this straight out, overdosing my fast-acting insulin, and it's saved me many, many times. So it's that second fingerprint that is generally more active. Lastly, I will not use my same fingers because you notice I said I do say 5 to 6 tests a day back to back. I will kind of rotate my fingers. And for most amount of comfort, I will use the lowest settings on that Lancet device that draws the most blood with the least amount of pain. All right. So if you found these general tips really helpful, please hit those alerts, that notification button, that gray bell on top of the screen, and of course, subscribe. If you like what you heard today, that like button, please share this with others. Especially those diabetics, you know, who may be struggling or looking to learn. Now, in the comment section, please feel free to tell me what kind of meter, what brand of meter do you use? And if so, why? All right? I would also like to know if you've had any struggles with taking your readings, how I could help. So in the end, folks, please have a great day, a productive week, and we will see you soon.